Hi, you've clicked on to today's tropical tidbit for Monday. Still not much going on in the Atlantic. We've got a big area of nothingness over here as the MJO takes a momentary vacation from our area of the world, promoting downward motion and dry air over most of our basin. We've got a well-defined tropical wave coming west of the Cape Verde Islands over here, and this will be coming westward over the next week or so. And just like Bonnie's wave, which looked just like this as a naked swirl, this will have to be watched for an increase in convection as it comes into a more moist environment and possibly more ventilated if there's a tut low there to help increase upper divergence over it and fire those thunderstorms just like Bonnie did when she got into this area. So we will keep an eye on that. The other thing to see over here is a tropical wave in the western Caribbean moving into the Yucatan this morning, and there's an upper low that's been following it westward over here, and this has been ventilating the area, and there's a little bit of upper ridging around this and a little bit of outflow starting to develop, so it's in a fairly favorable upper level environment, marginally favorable, not perfect, but it's decent. And if we take a close-up look at this, you can see that there's a strong shot of southeasterly winds coming into the thunderstorms over here, and then there's a weak bleeding northeast flow, very weak, but surface observations over Belize over here indicate that the winds turn from the northeast weakly. So we have this classic inverted V signature that we like to see with tropical waves, and this is a well-defined and vigorous wave. We've had winds out of Costa Maya east of Chetumal over here at 25 to 30 miles per hour sustained, with gusts over 40 to approaching 45 at times this morning. So this is a vigorous wave and some strong winds underneath these thunderstorms. If we look at the radar out of Belize, this is a little bit of a slow loop, but you can see if you look at the thing as a whole, there's a very broad weak area of low to mid-level rotation taking place in here. And it's not a closed low by any means or anything like that, but it's a broad level rotation showing us a vigorous wave coming across. Just to prove that I'm not lying to you, this is the CIMSS vorticity map for the 850 millibar level, and you can see a nice vortmax has developed just this morning, and there was nothing really here, not nearly as strong of a reflection last night or yesterday, so this has really improved in its presentation today with vorticity developing, and you can see where that corresponds to the sharp wave axis in here where the winds switch from southeast to northeast. So this is something that I would be more concerned about if it was not moving into the Yucatan today. If it was staying over water, it would probably try to develop a surface low today. At this time, I don't see it being too significant of a development threat when it comes across, but we will have to watch it. In the Bay of Campeche, the interesting thing about this system is that this upper low has been ventilating it and has been weakening because this wave has been releasing latent heat into the atmosphere because of all the convection going off, and it has weakened the upper low to the point that it's not hindering it as much as it was before, and it's far enough to the north that you can see the outflow starting to extend out from the thunderstorms in the recent hours. And so this is in a fairly decent environment for some possible development. This is the sneaky little devil I've been talking about. This was July 21st when Bonnie was back here, and this is the wave that's currently east of the Yucatan that was holding onto Bonnie's skirts over here. And Bonnie came out of the way, and this wave came by on its own. Still not sure why it's been labeled a tropical wave on the surface map, because that's what it is. This is definitely a tropical wave coming into the Yucatan over here. And this is yet another system coming west-northwest over Central America and towards northern Mexico. And I can't even count how many systems we've had that have done that now. We've had Tropical Depression 2, Hurricane Alex, Invest 98L, a couple other systems that just went in here and brought another shot of rain. And this is yet another shot of rain coming in there. So hopefully there aren't any more flooding problems from this. But, you know, it's an interesting little system. I don't expect significant development from this, but it should be watched. It's been a sneaky little devil so far, and it should be kept an eye on as it propagates west-northwestward over the next few days. Otherwise, a couple of fronts dropping down into this area off the southeast coast this week should be watched. The first one doesn't look to be too big of a problem. The second one, later this weekend and early next week, may try to spawn some weak areas of low pressure, possibly one backing down into the northern Gulf over here. And these things can be sneaky, homegrown mischief, can occur, and the water off the southeast coast is scary warm. So we'll be watching. Stalled fronts are never a good thing in the tropics in the middle of the summer, so we will be keeping an eye on that as well. This wave over here will be watched. Otherwise, a fairly quiet week to close out July is likely, and enjoy it while it lasts. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.